Gregory Evans Calloway, videographer, cinematographer, and photographer for Holy Angels Catholic Church in Chicago, Illinois, USA, narrates the monthly column of The Deacon Speaking by Deacon Bruce McElrath. This month's columns, Walk for Your Health and Cardinal Francis George, Small Faith in a Big God. The Deacon Speaking, Walk for Your Health. Physical exercise may help us fight off colds and infection. The theory is that good workouts puts our body in a condition similar to what happens at the onset of a fever. That's not all bad. A fever is the body's way of fighting back when micro-intruders get into our system. Increased body temperature aids our white blood cell defense system while slowing down the action of bacteria and viruses. Exercise does the same thing. It releases chemicals into the blood that stimulate the brain to make our temperature rise. The first two chapters of 1 John indicate that a regular practice of good spiritual exercise is beneficial to the health of our soul. To ward off sin, we must walk in the light as He is the light and obey Jesus each day. Disobedience, however, cools our spiritual temperature. Fellowship with God and other believers is neglected. Sin is neither confessed nor forsaken. If we have lukewarm faith, Revelation 3:16, we are not taking advantage of the defense mechanisms necessary to fight spiritual infection. The right exercise program is one of faith and obedience. It's essential to the spiritual health. Walk with Jesus every day and you'll truly be walking for your health. For a healthy heart, give your faith a workout. Stay on the battlefield, Deacon Bruce. Deacon Bruce McElrath, column. The Deacon Speaking. Cardinal Francis George, Small Faith in a Big God. Faith, we wish we all had more of it, especially when facing mountainous problems. Yet most of us are well practiced in faith. We sit down in chairs without checking them out. We use microwave ovens without analyzing how they work. We put keys in doors and expect them to open. We don't go around moaning, if only I had more faith in chairs and microwaves and keys. We depend upon these objects because we see them as reliable, not because we worked up great feelings of confidence. Jesus didn't say to his disciples, have more faith in God. He simply said, have faith in God, Mark 11:22. Cardinal George was a man of great faith. When things were at his worst in his life, he displayed his faith in God and displayed it for all to see. If he complained about the hand of life he was dealt, he merely informed all who asked, it is with my God who I trust that will make my way. I can remember one day while serving with him at a mass of St. Francis de Sales. There was a problem with his mobility, moving from the church to the school hall. Cardinal George merely said, God has given us an opportunity to display our ability to overcome the situation, and he did. We all admire a person who can overcome the worst challenges. Cardinal George had definitely displayed his ability to overcome obstacles from leading the archdiocese through all of his difficult moments to defeating the stigma of being handicapped, even to display to him his love of life by living through cancer. During his tenure, I had the pleasure of serving with him on several occasions, and it was indeed a pleasure because he always enjoyed and shared a joke, smiled, and words of encouragement, and he was truly a man of God, looking to serve the people of God. In forcing trials, many Christians agonized to obtain mountain-sized faith. But Jesus taught that faith, the size of a mustard seed, is sufficient. It planted in the soil of God's greatness. intruded in God's world with his faith. I can imagine Cardinal George listening to those wonderful words from God. Well done, my good and faithful servant. He can boost McAllister to stay on the backfield. Thank you. Have a great week.